For the one who was born in us on Christmas Day. Because the God we are waiting for, the God who was born as a child, it is on this day that God shows to us what He really is. That surely the joy we had for the baby Jesus is not a joy for just a baby, but a joy for God. A joy for a person who is our Redeemer and our Savior. The Gospel today, in the visit of the wise men, it shows to us how God has manifested Himself and has truly shown to us who He really is. The wise men came from the East. Most of us, we recall in our childhood, we refer to them as mere wise men. But these were kings. These were great people who came from the far ends of the world, from the East, to come. They paid homage to the born child. Kings from their kingdoms, kings, they come and pay homage. Homage which is only done to God. They themselves are such, though they are kings, they have come and they have seen the King of Kings. And therefore, they also bring gifts to the King of Kings. One brings gold. Gold, in a special way, is related to wealth. Only kings have the wealth to the standard of gold. Therefore, the one wise man who brings gold asserts in one way or the other that truly this born child is also a king. And since there are three of them assert this born child is a king. And on this day, the church already points to us that this child, throughout his life, is going to show to us that truly he is a king. Let us recall in the life of Jesus Christ, when he was before Pilate, Pilate asked him, "Are you truly a king?" And he said, "Yes, I am. As you say." Let us also look at the soldiers. The soldiers mocked him. They dressed him in a red robe. They crowned him with a crown of thorns. They didn't know what they were doing, but they also asserted, "Hail the King of the Jews." They didn't know that this was truly a king. The presentation of gold made to the child Jesus on this day, it is a show to us that truly this is a king. And Jesus, as we are going to journey in our liturgical year, is going to show fully how he is king. And those of us who look at Jesus as the earthly king, himself in his words, is going to remind us, "My kingdom is not of this world." And therefore, his kingdom, the crown he has, it is not of gold, it is not of silver, but of thorns. His throne, where he sits, is not sitting on a very expensive throne made of gold, made of wood. No, it is not a throne that is well decorated, but a throne of the cross, that on the cross is going to hang with his crown on the head. And upon it we shall surely say, "He is the King of Kings." Pilate will again assert, Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. Because Jesus is King, today on the Epiphany of the Lord, it is a celebration that the born child has revealed to us that he is a king, and above all, a king of kings. And when he also says, his kingdom is not of this world, he reminds us that having been in this world, he showed to us he's a king. When he goes in heaven, he sits on the right hand of the Father in his kingdom, where he awaits all those who believe in him, all those who are faithful in him. The second wise man brought to the child Jesus frankincense. Incense, we normally use it when we are praying, in our prayer, when we are relating to spiritual beings. But today, the incense to the born child is not burnt, it is not smoke out of incense, but incense brought to the child, given to the child, because he is God. They are already showing us that this born child, he himself is God. And throughout the church choir, as we are journeying with the words and the life of Christ, Christ himself is going to show to us that really he is God. He's going to manifest in his life how he is God. There are so many things we have learned about God. There are so many things on which we can say God has these characteristics. And Jesus is going to manifest all these. For example, we studied that God is all-knowing. God is all-forgiving. God has no beginning and it has no end. This, Jesus is going to show them to us. Let us recall Nathanael. When Philip told him, I have seen the Messiah. When Nathanael comes to the Lord, Jesus tells him, Nathanael, I saw you under the tree even before Philip told you about me. Jesus shows that he already knew even before Nathanael had come. The knowledge of God, all knowing. Let us recall when the apostles, his disciples, they found him at the well with the woman. When they wanted to give him something to eat, and he said, no, I have already eaten, I don't need to eat. And inside their hearts, they were like, maybe someone has given to him. And he said, you don't have to, why do you have such thoughts in your hearts? He already knows even what we have not said. Let us recall the sins he forgave. He forgave people the community was ready to kill. He forgave the sinful woman. The people we are bedridden, he healed them by only saying, your sins are forgiven. And this is how God forgives. That God is all forgiving. That no matter what other people say, God is all forgiving. And Jesus manifested this. Above the eternity of God, let us recall when he talked about the temple. And he said, when this temple be put down, I'll build it up in 3 days. Because I was there, even before Moses, even before. So he already shows us Christ himself, though he is born today, he has already reflected to us that truly he is God. And more so in the words he says to John. When John asked him, Lord, show us your Father. And Jesus said, John, having seen me, you have seen my Father, because I am in him and he is in me. Therefore, Christ himself is God. The incense that is brought to him today, given to him, and the homage that proves that truly he is God, he himself, throughout the liturgical year, is going to prove that truly he is God. Lastly, Jesus was given mirror. This is the oil that is anointed to the dead body. The born child, we have been rejoicing, and we are still rejoicing by the birth of Christ. But by his birth, having been born, he had to die. But his death is not like any of our deaths. That's why, even from birth, he's given the oil that will be anointed at his death. Because his death is a death that's going to bring redemption. This born child is going to bring out what Truly, it means to love, the true love, and these are going to be manifested in his love by dying for us. And truly, when he says, nobody loves more than a person who gives up his life for his friends, these are going to be manifested truly in Jesus, this one child. So today, as we celebrate the Epiphany of our Lord, we are really showing that our God has manifested himself. Our God has shown to us who he really is. So you have to celebrate. Today it is a day of great joy. The light which we have been yearning for years has been manifested in Christ. When the three wise men were coming to see the born child, they followed a star. In that, God has used all the old, all the things of the old. People worshipped the sun. People worshipped the moon. People looked at the stars for direction. People looked at light in the born child. The true light has been received. When the wise men reached where the star was, they found the born child. And therefore, we do not have to look again in the skies. We do not have to look again in the created creatures. We do not have to look again in anything else, but only in Jesus Christ, the true light. Therefore, as we celebrate the Epiphany of our Lord, the church today calls upon you and me, dear brothers and sisters. If you are looking for a king, if you are looking for a master of your life, look at this. He is a true king, and whatever we want, he will give them to us. That we can come always and say, Jesus is the king of our lives. We can always say, Jesus is the master of our lives. And those who are looking for true friends, Jesus is our friend, and he is willing to sacrifice himself for us, such that we can be redeemed, such that we can be saved. And above all, this born child Jesus Christ is God. May we not look anywhere when we are looking for God, but in Jesus Christ. And he himself reminds us, through him we can reach God the Father. With him and in him we can be with God the Father. Let us not abandon him. Let us always turn to him, because whatever we are looking for in this one born child, Jesus Christ, we shall find. The first reading, in another way, it calls us to mind. Many people think when Jesus ascended into heaven, the light disappeared from the world. Many people think when Jesus left, therefore he left and he is nowhere. But the second reading is telling you and me, arise, you Jerusalem, arise, because the light has been shown in you. Today, the New Jerusalem is the church, and in a special way, the Catholic Church. In the church, in this New Jerusalem, the true light has been manifested. In the Word of God, in the sacraments, in the ministers of the Lord, that wherever we go, wherever we preach, wherever we administer sacraments, the true light of God is manifested and darkness is covered. You fellow Christian, you fellow Catholic, today is the Sunday on which we are all called upon. May we rise again. You and me, may the light receive that baptism. May the sharing in the light of Jesus Christ received at baptism, may we bring it forth in our faith in God, in our love to God, and in love of neighbor. May we bring this love, this light, this justice into the world, such that together we can rejoice and say that truly the light of God has been manifested in New Jerusalem. The light of God is manifested in his church, and we, me and you, are the church. Me and you are the light of the world. The second reading, in a special way, reminds to us that this born child is God, and in being God, He is not for any tribe. He is not for any culture. But for all peoples. We do not have Gentiles. We do not have pagans. We do not have a special race. We do not have a special people before God. Because God is for us all. And therefore, in this new Jerusalem, in this new church, the Catholic Church, this comes out well when all languages, when all peoples, when everyone joins in one voice to praise God the Father. As we say, we are one, irrespective of our difference in cultures, irrespective of our geographical locations, irrespective of our tribes, that we are one. Therefore, we are called upon as one. May we rise, and so may the light of God enlighten the whole world. The Lord be with you.
Song of praise unto our God. Let him place his new song in your mouth. It's a song of praise unto our God. Let him place his new song in your mouth. It's a song of praise unto our God.